In this tutorial, I'll show you three ways to create a tunnel-shaped mesh. Let's create a ground plane and scale it. For the first example, I'll use a cylinder. Let's type R, X, and 90 to rotate the mesh 90 degrees on the X axis. In edit mode, type 3 to face select, shift select two end faces like this, and type I as in India to extrude inward. Let's delete the selected faces. Type 2 to edge select. Shift select the two edge loops like this, and bridge edge loop them. Let's right click to shade smooth the mesh. In order to make this look good after subdividing it, we need to add some loop cuts. I have used Ctrl R to place a loop cut, and used mouse wheel up to add one more. I'm going to scale them apart like this. We need two more loops on the inside. This was the first method. The first method is only good for perfectly round tunnel meshes. We'll use a subdivided cube for the second example. We're repeating the same steps to create a tunnel mesh with a cube. The only difference is how we're subdividing right at the beginning. Even the bridging edge loops part is identical. We can control the shape of the tunnel-shaped mesh much better than the cylindrical example with loop cuts. We'll need loop cuts on the inside for this mesh as well. The last example is my favorite, because it's faster and easier than the previous examples. Now we have two tunnel-shaped meshes, but we can see their distinctive features. I'll show you a possible bug that I've encountered here. I was using a single vert to extrude from the world center. When I typed G and Z to move it up, or E to extrude, nothing appeared. The yellow dot we just saw moving upward was the single vert's origin indicator. When I tried to extrude it, nothing appeared either. I'll try again. When this issue occurs, just create a plane, go to edit mode, type 1 to vertex select, and M to merge at the center. Now we can extrude the vertex to create our tunnel shape. Hold Ctrl to snap the vertex like this. Ctrl B to bevel, and V as in Victor to vertex bevel. Mouse wheel up or down to add or remove vertices. Just a minute. I can't see anything. I'll change the theme. We can create any tube-shaped meshes easily this way. The idea is to mirror it, duplicate it, and bridge edge loop it. Type G twice to vertex slide. Let's apply the mirror modifier and press Ctrl 3 to subdivide. Shift D to duplicate, Ctrl J to join both edges and bridge edge loop them. I'll need some loop cuts. I'll solidify the mesh. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.